Welcome to part two of the Texas Medical Center Library video series on performing a literature search in PubMed. This video describes how to use MeSH as part of your PubMed literature search strategy. While this lecture focuses on PubMed, the search strategies we describe can be used in most medical literature databases. When conducting a thorough literature search in PubMed, the first step is to identify the MeSH for each concept in your research question. MeSH stands for Medical Subject Headings and is a controlled vocabulary used in Medline. You can think of MeSH terms as labels or tags that the database assigns to each article. Every article in PubMed is indexed using this vocabulary. One way to demonstrate the importance of using subject headings is to think about situations in which different terms are used for the same concept, such as in the case of the term heart attack. Authors may refer to this concept using terms like myocardial infarction, myocardial necrosis, or cardiovascular stroke. If you search for articles using only one of these terms, you may miss relevant articles. Subject headings solve this problem by assigning a particular word or phrase to represent a concept. In this case, for example, PubMed groups all these terms together under one subject heading, myocardial infarction. You can also think of MeSH terms as hashtags. In the case of social media posts, the person creating the post decides which hashtags best fit the content of their post. In the case of MeSH terms, human subject experts analyze each article submitted to the database to determine which subject headings best describe the content of the article. To search for MeSH related to your topic, click on the MeSH database link from within PubMed. Enter the keywords associated with your research question one at a time. As we did in the previous video, let's use this research question. What are the risk factors associated with childhood myeloid leukemia? Our research question can be broken down into three concepts: myeloid leukemia, children, and risk factors. Let's enter the concept of myeloid leukemia into the MeSH database. The assigned MeSH for myeloid leukemia is leukemia, myeloid. We are also shown additional headings that relate to our topic. For now, let's select the subject heading of myeloid leukemia. Clicking on the subject heading brings us to the full MeSH record for our term, including its definition, the year the term was introduced in MeSH, and a list of optional subheadings for the term, associated entry terms, and its place in the subject heading hierarchy. If you wish, you may select one or more subheadings to further refine your search. However, it is generally recommended to use these subheadings sparingly, especially at the start of the research process, as doing so potentially eliminates relevant articles. It's important to examine the scope note for your MeSH term and make sure that the definition fits the meaning you intend. Words or phrases in all caps is PubMed's way of indicating that a related subject heading exists for this term. You may want to investigate this further to see if you can find alternate or additional MeSH headings for your topic. Particularly if you're looking for older records, you may want to look at the year the term was introduced in the MeSH. PubMed does not retroactively assign new subject headings to old records. If you need articles on this topic that date prior to the year listed, you'll need to use the old MeSH heading, which is found further down in the MeSH record. The entry terms are synonyms, alternate forms, and other closely related words and phrases related to myeloid leukemia. These phrases are useful when building a keyword search bank, which we will cover in the next video. Lastly, the subject heading hierarchy shows us where our term appears in the MeSH tree. This is a useful tool for determining whether or not we want to introduce broader or more specific terms into our search strategy. Including all narrower terms underneath a subject heading is called exploding. For this particular search, I want to include all of the narrower concepts for myeloid leukemia. In other words, I want to explode my search. For that reason, I will be sure to leave this button unchecked. You can also restrict your search results to those articles that include myeloid leukemia as a major topic only. This will eliminate the results that include this concept as a secondary or minor topic and narrow your search results significantly. In this case, I'm going to leave the box unchecked to cast as wide a net as possible. Once you've made your selections, click on the button Add to Search Builder. Click on Search PubMed to execute your search. By using the subject headings, we can be certain that our search results will be precise. However, the list of results we get may not be complete. There are a few reasons for this. There is often a time lag when it comes to indexing articles. Thousands of new articles are submitted to PubMed every week, and though subject experts are efficient, they're not computers. It takes time to analyze articles, assign mesh, and update records in the database. Sometimes there is no mesh for the concept you're interested in. Or you may be searching for a concept that was recently introduced in mesh. Relying on the mesh alone may eliminate those articles that were written before PubMed started assigning that mesh to articles. For all of these reasons, when conducting a thorough literature search in PubMed, it's important to combine a subject heading search with a keyword search for every concept in your topic question. In our next video, we'll follow the next step in the literature search process by conducting both a mesh search and a keyword search for each concept in our topic question. If you have questions about searching PubMed, please contact a librarian.